Don't be greedy. A white crane with one of its leg up was standing near a beautiful lake. But its heart was filled with worries.
I have become old. I cannot go from lake to lake in search of fish for my living. So I have got to come out with an idea for this. What shall I do?
All of a sudden, the crane's mind was filled with a wicked thought. After some time, the crane paused as if it was very, very sad. A crab passing by noticed the crane's face.
Sister, why are you worried?
What can I tell you? I am very much worried about you and your fish friends.
What are you telling, sister? Why should you get worried about us?
What are you asking, brother? When you are so affectionate and call me sister, will I not have half of your affection?
Tell me in detail, sister.
Brother, there is a new astrologer who's come to this place. You know what he said?
How will I know? Tell me.
Listen, it seems there will be no rain this year in our place. In a few days' time, this lake will get dried up and there will be no water. So you and your fish friends have to die.
Oh my God, what can I do, sister?
That's why I've come up with a good idea. But I don't know whether all of you will listen to me or not.
Why are you telling like this, sister? We listen to whatever you say.
Nothing much. There is a stream nearby with full of water and it will not get dry. I thought I myself could safely take you all there.
Good idea. I'll go immediately and tell Mother Fish and her kids about this and bring them here all together.
There's nothing wrong in telling the matter, but don't bring all of them together. If it's a big fish, bring 2 per day and 4 if it's small. That's enough. This is all I can eat.
Yes, yes. You too should be able to carry them, isn't it? Okay, sister. I'll take leave. So when are you going to take us there?
I shall start my job from tomorrow. From the next day onwards, the crane took as many fishes as possible in its long sharp beak to a rock and ate them happily. It acted as though it was doing a favor for the fishes and the crabs without expecting anything in return. It got fed up of eating fishes every day. Why can't I cheat the crab and eat it? Thought the crane. It called the crab. The crab climbed onto the back of the crane. The crane flew. The crab saw fish bones on the rock while traveling on the crane's back. It got shocked.
You cheater, crane. I've lost so many of my fish friends by believing you. So, you're going to eat me also like this,
it thought.
Before it kills me to eat, I've got to finish it off,
the crab decided. All of a sudden, the crab crushed the crane's neck with its sharp claws and killed it. Then it went back to its place and narrated the whole incident.
Morning. The crane wished to eat both the fish and the crab, but its greediness led to its death. So, dear children, be happy with whatever you have.